हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम यू ऑल। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट जनरेशन ऑफ हाई डीसी वोल्टेजेस। इंट्रोडक्शन। इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ हाई वोल्टेज डीसी एंड एसी। हाई वोल्टेज डीसी रिक्वायर फॉर इंडस्ट्री, मेडिकल साइंसेस एंड एचवीडीसी ट्रांसमिशन। एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ हाई वोल्टेज डीसी। इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक प्रेसिपिटेटर इन थर्मल पावर प्लांट फॉर द एस हैंडलिंग यूनिट। इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक पेंट, सीमेंट इंडस्ट्री एट्सेट्रा। एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ हाई वोल्टेज एसी। इट इज़ यूज्ड इन द पावर ट्रांसमिशन फॉर लॉन्ग डिस्टेंसेस। जनरेशन ऑफ हाई डीसी वोल्टेज। सो देर आर थ्री मेथड्स ऑफ फॉर जनरेशन ऑफ हाई डीसी वोल्टेजेस। वन इज रेक्टिफायर सर्किट्स, सेकेंड वन इज 1D ग्राफ जनरेटर्स, थर्ड वन इज कोक्रॉफ्ट वोल्टन टाइप हाई वोल्टेज डीसी सेट। फर्स्ट वी विल सी द रेक्टिफायर सर्किट्स फॉर प्रोड्यूसिंग हाई डीसी वोल्टेजेस फ्रॉम एसी सोर्सेस। सो देर आर थ्री मेथड्स। वन इज अ हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर, सेकेंड वन इज फुल वेव रेक्टिफायर एंड थर्ड वन इज वोल्टेज डबलर सर्किट्स। Here we can see two figures. First one is for half wave rectifier and second circuit diagram is for full wave rectifier. Now in half wave rectifier we can see one diode, input transformer, one capacitor and RL, it means load resistance. So working of half wave rectifier is very simple. Input is given is AC wave. So we know that in a sinusoidal waveform, there in one cycle there is two half cycles, one positive half cycle and one negative half cycle. So during positive half cycle, diode becomes forward bias and we get the output voltage, and during negative half cycle, diode becomes reverse bias. So we cannot get any output during negative half cycle. So we can see in the waveform, this is the input supply voltage and this is the waveform for half wave rectifier. Now we see the full wave rectifier. There are two diodes are there, A and B are diodes, and C stands for filter. As we know that the output of the rectifier is not pure DC, but it is pulsating type. So we have to use filter circuit for that. And in this circuit, we have used capacitor for filtering. In a full wave rectifier, there are also positive half cycle and negative half cycle. So during a positive half cycle, diode A will become forward bias and diode B will become reverse bias. You can see the here is the diode A and here is the diode B. So during a positive half cycle, only diode A will conduct and we will get the output in a positive half cycle. And during the negative half cycle, diode A will become reverse bias and diode B will become forward bias. So we get the output in negative half cycle also. So in this case, we can see the output in both positive and negative half cycles. And last waveform is ripple voltage. Generation of high DC voltage. So we have seen two methods, half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier. There is one limitation. We can get maximum output voltage up to V maximum. But if we our requirement is more than the V maximum, then we have to use voltage doubler circuit. This is nothing but voltage doubler circuit. So in this circuit, capacitor is used and output of the this circuit will be double the input voltage. Here we have used the properties of capacitor. Here we can see the capacitor C1. So during the 1/2 cycle, capacitor will be charged up to V maximum, and this voltage will be added to the output. So we get the output voltage is V plus V is equal to 2V. So this way we can double the input voltage. Second figure is also for voltage doubler circuit, but it is a cascaded voltage doubler circuit. So output of this circuit is also double the input voltage. So this is also we can use for high DC voltage generation. Now 1D graph generator, it is a type of electrostatic generator. It generates high potential differences. Then the generated potential differences are used to speed up the particles like ions, etc. So it is a particle accelerator. Application of this type of generator is in nuclear physics experiments. The potential difference achieved in modern 1D graph generators can reach 5 megavolts. So it is a very very large voltages. A 1D graph generator operates by transferring electric charge from a moving belt to a terminal. We will see later this, how can we transfer the electric charge. Working of the generator is based on two principles. Discharging action of sharp points, it means electric discharge takes place in air or gases readily at point conductors. If the charged conductor is brought into a internal contact with a hollow conductor, all of its charge transfers to the surface of the hollow conductor, no matter how high the potential of the latter may be. How the charge is spread in hollow conductor, we will see in the next slide. Applications: accelerating electrons to sterilize food and process materials, accelerating protons for nuclear physics experiments, driving X-ray tubes, etc. These are the applications of 1D graph generator. Now construction. Here we can see the figure of 1D graph generator. Starts from bottom. One number is stands for lower spray points. Two number label is motor driven pulley. Number three is insulated belt. Four number is high voltage terminal. Fifth one is collector. Sixth one is upper pulley insulated from terminal. Seventh one is upper spray point, and eight is earthed enclosure. So these are the parts of the 1D graph generator. Now what is the working principle, or how the charge is spread in the holosphere? So in this figure we can see the belt is placed in two pulleys. So pulleys are made from metals, and belt is insulated made from insulated materials. So from lower points, positive charge will travel through this belt up to upper point. And fifth one is label number five is collector. So charge is collected from the collector at upper spray point, and it is spread in the holosphere. So this way the charge is spread in the holosphere, and very high voltage is generated. ए सिंपल 1D ग्राफ जनरेटर कॉन्सिस्ट ऑफ ए बेल्ट ऑफ सिल्क और ए सिमिलर फ्लेक्सिबल डाइलेक्ट्रिक मटेरियल रनिंग ओवर टू मेटल पुलीज दैट वी हैव सीन इन द कंस्ट्रक्शन. द जनरेटर इज यूजुअली एनक्लोज्ड इन एन अर्थड मेटालिक सिलिंड्रिकल वेसल एंड इज ऑपरेटेड अंडर प्रेशर और इन वैक्यूम. चार्ज इज स्प्रेड ऑन टू एन इंसुलेटिंग मूविंग बेल्ट फ्रॉम कोरोना पॉइंट्स. Require the potential of 10 to 100 kV. The belt is driven by an electric motor at a speed of 1000 to 2000 meter per unit. Potential of a high voltage electrode rises in the rate of dV by dt is equal to I upon C into dQ upon dt. It is equal to I upon C, where I is the charging current. The shape of electrodes are spherical that we have seen in the construction. The charging of the belt is done by the lower spray points, which are sharp needles and connected to a DC source of about 10 to 100 kilovolt, so that the corona is maintained between the moving belt and the needles. Belt has self-charging system. So this is all about 1D graph generator. Thank you.